Blackmagic Cloud is a cloud-based service that allows you to collaborate on DaVinci Resolve projects with users located anywhere in the world, or with yourself when working on different computers, or on the same computer but in different locations. Among other things, it can be used to host DaVinci Resolve projects. They contain your timelines, bins, metadata, and effects. Essentially, all your work. It can be used to host media, all the video clips and audio files that you're using to create your edits. Quick vocab lesson. What's the difference between Blackmagic Cloud and the Blackmagic Cloud Store? Blackmagic Cloud lives in the cloud. It's the service used to host your projects and media. Blackmagic Cloud Store lives in your office. It's a network-attached storage device. It's only accessible on your home or office network. For today, we will show you how to get started using Blackmagic Cloud to share your projects and media. Let's begin. There's four simple steps. Create a free Blackmagic Cloud ID, purchase a Blackmagic Cloud plan, configure your project library, start working in Resolve. First, you will need a Blackmagic Cloud ID. It's the login that you will use to purchase and access Blackmagic Cloud. Head to blackmagicdesign.com and click on the cloud icon in the top right-hand corner. Accounts are free to create. Second, in order to create a project library, you must have an active plan. Plans can be configured in account settings. Go to Manage Plan. You can see I'm currently on the free plan. While it comes with 2 GB of storage, I cannot host any project libraries. Let's fix that. Click Upgrade Plan. My needs are simple. I only need a single project library. With tax included, that's still less than £6 per month. A library can store up to 1,000 projects. You can share that library with up to 30 different users. While 30 people can use a library simultaneously, only 10 users can access a project simultaneously. I will demonstrate two different scenarios, storing my media on an external drive and storing my media on Blackmagic Cloud. So I will include storage in my plan. 0.5 TB of storage only costs an additional £6.50 before tax. That's amazing value. It's worth considering how much more this amount of storage would cost you on an alternate service. If you live in a different region, the price will be shown in your local currency. Remember, this is optional. You can store your media on external drives or use an alternative cloud service like Dropbox. It's good to know that you can cancel your plan at any time. There's no minimum term. This means you can adjust your spend to suit your current workload. One last step before we can get going in Resolve. Our plan now allows us to have a single project library. We still need to create it. Head to Project Server. As we don't have any project libraries yet, the interface for creating a new project library has automatically loaded. Choose a name. I'm going to call mine Travel Docs. Next, we need to choose a region. This allows us to control where our project server is hosted. It's best practice to choose the nearest location. This will ensure the least latency when accessing your project library. I'm choosing London. Finally, click Add. Here's my project library. I can see information and access additional options by clicking on this icon. As you can see, I'm currently the only one with access. I can add additional members to this library by hitting Share. Before we continue, can we show you how we find music for our videos? Most library music websites feature filters that allow you to search by mood, genre, and instrumentation. Even then, it can still be hard finding the right music for the edit. Audiio has just launched a brand new AI assistant called Hans AI that helps you to find the music for your videos. Simply describe the kind of video you need to score, and Audiio's AI will suggest 6 tracks that might fit it. Alternatively, you can use Link Match. Feed it a song you like, and it will find tracks from Audiio's library that match the genre, style, and energy. We love it when AI is used to enhance our creativity rather than replace it. Audiio has a ton of other features you'll love, like themes, so you can more easily remix the music. But we think your favorite feature will be the incredible price. Using our discount code, you can get an entire year of Audiio for only $60. A big thank you to Audiio for supporting our videos. When you open Resolve, it loads the Project Manager. This interface allows you to load projects from your library. The tabs along the top left allow you to choose whether you are accessing a local library, a network-based library, or a cloud library. Click Cloud. As this is my first time accessing my cloud library, I need to log in. I will demonstrate two different scenarios: storing my media on an external drive and storing my media on Blackmagic Cloud. Let's make a new project. Whenever you create a new project on a cloud library, this dialog appears. I'll call this project Mountains. This option here allows me to control whether or not more than one person can access the project simultaneously. There's presently no need to enable this option. I can enable it later if I want to. This option chooses whether or not my media gets uploaded to Blackmagic Cloud. I'm going to choose not to sync my media. So as mentioned, I can demonstrate a workflow without media being on the cloud. Click Create. And now I can import my media from my drive. Let me make a quick edit. I'll just throw some clips quickly into a timeline. It won't be compelling, but it's enough to demonstrate. This is my desktop setup in my office space. This is my laptop I use when traveling. It's time to head out. Resolve is installed on my laptop. Just like in the office, I need to log into my Blackmagic Cloud account. Of course, wherever you are, you will need an internet connection. I can be halfway around the world or just in my kitchen and see the same project I created. Let's open the project. I can see all the bins. I can see my timeline, I can see the edits that have been made, but all the media is showing as offline. I can fix that because I've brought a drive with me that contains all the media. It doesn't have to be the same drive, you can make multiple copies, but it does have to contain the same media. Let's get it connected. I can relink my media by hitting this icon and navigating to the folder where the media is stored. Any changes I make to the project on this laptop will automatically be available on my desktop computer. This is a great way of using Blackmagic Cloud to collaborate with yourself. This workflow required me to manage my own media. While I could access the project from any computer anywhere in the world, I wouldn't have been able to continue editing if I didn't bring my media with me. I could have used a service like Dropbox, Google Drive, or Apple's iCloud to share the media between computers. But even easier than that, I'm going to show you how to share media with Blackmagic Cloud. Next scenario, let's start from scratch. I will make a new project. This one is going to be called Cities. This time I'm going to enable multi-user collaboration, and I'm also going to choose to share my media, both originals and proxies, in the cloud. By the way, original media is what you need to make your high-quality final renders. Because those files are big, they can take time to sync between computers. Proxy media is a lower quality version of your media that can sync quicker, allowing you to start working immediately. As soon as I import media into the project, you can see that DaVinci Resolve starts uploading that footage to Blackmagic Cloud. Remember, this is only possible because I added media storage to my plan. All right, it's time to grab my laptop and head out again. Like before, I'm logged into my cloud account. This time, I have no drives with me. I'll open the project I created. Please take note of the fact that I have sync proxies and originals selected. Initially, the media shows as offline, but if I check the cloud status, you can see it's busy downloading the footage. So already, I can see that the footage in my bins is starting to show online. And again, any changes I make here will appear when I'm back at my desk. One last thing. Remember I enabled allow multiple users? That means I can invite other creators into this project while I'm still in it. We could collaborate together from different parts of the world in the same project. Let's invite Leon into the project. As I'm hosting the project in media, he can benefit from my plan. He needs his own Blackmagic Cloud ID, but he doesn't need to spend any money. I can add him to the project library via the web interface that I used earlier to configure my Blackmagic Cloud ID. On his computer, he can log into Blackmagic Cloud using his own personal Cloud ID. Now he can see my project library and the projects I created. When he opens the project, his computer will begin syncing media, just like mine did. It looks like Leon is currently working in the capture bin. I know that because Resolve shows his initials next to it. When using Blackmagic Cloud to share media, you're not editing directly from the cloud. Instead, Blackmagic Cloud is being used to synchronize data between your computers. That's because you need the fastest possible access to your media for smooth editing, and it's always going to be fastest when it's on your computer. Blackmagic Cloud is a great way of collaborating with other creatives. It's also a great way of collaborating with yourself across multiple computers or locations. It's as easy as registering an account, purchasing a plan, and creating a project. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, consider sharing it, and subscribe to see more helpful videos like this.